Fierce winds are now whipping Florida as Hurricane Irma creeps closer to areas too dangerous to stay.
This is your last chance to make a good decision. More than 6.5 million Floridians have been ordered to evacuate. Do not put yourself or your family's life at risk.
This message sent Floridians fleeing to safer grounds. Residents queued up for hours in snaking lines.
I'll get through this together. I'm here as well. I was displaced as well, so I'm right here with you.
But with just 320 evacuation centers throughout the state, many were turned away.
We're stupid. We should have come to the shelters a day or two ago.
Irma is expected to strengthen to Category 5 when it makes a direct hit on Florida. That still wasn't enough to evacuate the stubborn.
This is the western view over the beautiful Gulf of Mexico. I'm not that worried about it because a hurricane damage is primarily water rising, and I'm on 17-4.
This expert breaks down Irma's expected path.
Here's what we look for as far as the landfall. It's going to be sometime Sunday morning in the Keys. It will continue during...
Zookeepers in Miami scrambled to secure as many animals as they could, while larger ones were kept in their hurricane-proof enclosures. Clear, as Irma packed winds of 200 kilometers per hour, it uprooted trees and ripped apart homes in Cuba. St. Martin is one of the worst hit. Countless residents have been rendered homeless. Right after Francis...
9月16日下午2点，到店即可获得价值八千。
Territories of Saint Martin and Saint Barthélemy. Officials in London are doing the same for the British Virgin Islands.
In total, we have some 500 troops in the region by tonight, and we have 2 to 3 flights going out each day, bringing further troops, further engineers, medical support, pallets of aid.
Right as Irma pounded the U.S. Virgin Islands, Navy sailors rescued patients in need of emergency care.
It's a beautiful day to share life by giving blood. One blood donation can save 3 or more lives. Share life, give blood. You can do it. Everyone can choose their pathway, straight or curved. There's no need to follow others. Make your own choice.
Vocational and professional education and training covers a wide range of occupations and includes relevant programs up to degree level. It provides practical training to better prepare the younger generation for their future careers and helps them to enter a profession. VPEP, leading you to a professional pathway.
From the 1st of May 2017, the statutory minimum wage is raised to $34.50 per hour. Employees covered by the minimum wage ordinance are entitled to this rate regardless of their mode of employment. Employees with disabilities can opt for assessment and receive wages according to the productivity assessed. For details, please call 2717-1771 or visit the Labor Department website.
The vision of Hong Kong 2030 Plus is to make Hong Kong a more livable, competitive, and sustainable metropolis. First, people-centric planning, livable compact city. Second, diversifying our economy and embracing new challenges. And third, enhancing development and environmental capacity for sustainable growth. Share your views on or before April 30th.
我是发团通告，通知你嚟紧要。
Turning to local news, a member of the government-backed panel on land supply has praised Chief Executive Carrie Lam's proposal for a scheme on starter homes. This one aims to help young families get on the property ladder. Our Rachel Lung with you.
Buying a flat in Hong Kong isn't getting any cheaper, but it's not impossible either. Under the administration's new approach, young families may be able to get on the property ladder with the help of a new starter home scheme. The proposal is expected to be the highlight of Chief Executive Carrie Lam's first policy address next month. Speaking to CCTV News, a member of the task force on land supply, Lo Chung Kong, the plan would target locals who are not eligible for public housing but cannot afford a flat in the private sector.
You need, first of all, to check the right group of people to go into this. And then, after they have been living there for a few years, if they have the affordability, they then move on to the next tier, to the private sector.
So, how would this work? This leader earlier proposed a public-private partnership scheme to allow private developers to build the starter homes. The surveyor praised the plan, saying that it may open up doors for future land supply in the city.
You'll be able to see that. The prime target could be agricultural land, which is suitable for residential use. If certain land parcels have been able to be identified, and then to get through the town planning, infrastructure constraint, go through the land premium process, then there will be supply of these new type of development land.
Currently, under the city's existing subsidized housing sale program, the home ownership scheme, HOS flat owners can sell their units freely in the secondary market after paying a land premium based on the amount discounted from the original purchase price. Lau suggested that since these new starter homes are likely to fetch a lower price than HOS flats, there should be limitations on the resale of these starter units. Rachel Lang, CTV News.
Protesters marched to Government House this morning, demanding universal retirement protection. Meanwhile, the Labor and Welfare Chief says the city will be hit hard as the population ages.
Chief Executive Carrie Lam introduced a universal retirement protection program in her upcoming policy address next month. They said with its huge fiscal surplus, the government has the ability to introduce non-means-tested universal retirement protection. The group also slammed Lam for refusing to meet them, despite having sent her numerous invitations. Meanwhile, Secretary for Labor and Welfare Lo Chi Kwong addressed the problem of an aging population today. Law stated in his blog that the population of people aged 65 or above was 1.2 million in 2016, according to latest government figures. That figure is projected to reach 2.6 million by 2066. But he admitted manpower for primary elderly care is sorely lacking at the moment. Law noted that the problem of an aging population in Hong Kong will be severe in the future. He even described the problem as none. He said the government is currently preparing for October's policy address and the allocation of resources for the upcoming year. He promised his bureau will try its best to fight for resources to improve elderly services. Law also noted that, as the local labor force is shrinking, the Labor Department will introduce measures to promote elderly employment in response. Caleb Leung, TVB News.
Overseas again, Rohingya resurgence have declared a month-long unilateral ceasefire starting today. The move would aid groups to help ease a humanitarian crisis in northwestern Myanmar.
Wave after wave of hungry and traumatized Rohingya refugees from Myanmar continue to pour into neighboring Bangladesh. This follows attacks by the Arakan Rohingya South Asian Army, or ASA, insurgents on 30 police posts and an army base on August 25th. The Myanmar military's subsequent counter-offensive has forced nearly 300,000 Rohingya to flee to Bangladesh, with another 30,000 non-Muslim civilians displaced inside Myanmar. Over the past fortnight, thousands of homes have been burned down, dozens of villages uprooted, and thousands of people are still on the move towards the border with Bangladesh. The growing humanitarian crisis has strained aid agencies and local communities, already helping hundreds of thousands displaced by previous waves of violence. It led the insurgent group to declare a month-long unilateral ceasefire. In a statement, the ASA encouraged all concerned humanitarian actors to resume their assistance to all victims of the crisis. The group, which has been branded a terrorist organization by the Myanmar government, also called on the military to lay down arms and allow aid to all affected people. The move comes as the ASA struggles to put up significant resistance against the military force unleashed in Myanmar's northwestern Rakhine state. Rights monitors and fleeing Rohingya say the army and Rakhine Buddhist vigilantes have mounted a campaign of arson aimed at driving out the Muslim population. Meanwhile, aid workers say a serious humanitarian crisis is also unfolding on the Myanmar side of the border. Red Cross organizations are scaling up their operations in Rakhine after the United Nations had to suspend activities there following government suggestions its agency had supported the insurgents. Thousands of people displaced from Rakhine have been stranded or left without food for weeks, with many still trying to cross mountains and dense bush to reach Bangladesh.
Slow moving funeral processions were causing gridlocks in the southern Mexican city of Xochitlán. This comes as residents are starting to get to grips with the monster earthquake that struck on Friday. Cemeteries swelled with mourners for the dead as pallbearers carried the caskets around the rubble. At least 37 people died in Xochitlán as buildings collapsed in the magnitude 8.1 quake. The monster quake and hurricane have combined to take at least 67 lives in the country.
As for Hurricane Katia, residents in Mexico are beginning to survey the damage it left behind. Katia pelted Veracruz State with intense rain. Residents also endured winds that reached 120 kilometers per hour. Two people died in a mudslide related to that storm, but there were no reports of major damage. And still to come on our newscast, woman badly hurt after fall to Josh's paper furnace. Benefit concert for the victims of Manchester arena bombing. And Sloane Stephens triumphs in U.S. Open final.
Blood 胸闷心痛都是血管瘀堵造成的担心补心茶空血管化瘀堵防意外血管痛了心慌空闷血管痛了血压血脂正常血管畅通全身轻松空闷心痛血压高饮天草丹参补心茶每日三代健康常在 年轻就要醒着拼，累了困了，喝东城特饮。风湿火病，好，67味药材好，身心要拼的老毛病。
每天早晚喝红毛，才是中华老字号。来，兔宝宝，荆州的红毛药酒。
是一样的吗？我们怎么来提升博主？一方面要靠大量的阅读，另外一方面呢，就是阅历了。
Welcome back. A woman is in critical condition after she fell into a Joss paper furnace at a Taoist temple this morning. Three firefighters were all injured while trying to rescue her. Our Caleb Wong has that story.
The incident happened at around 10:30 this morning at the Yunyun Institute in Xinjiang. The 59-year-old woman was in a coma after she was rescued by firefighters. She was taken to Princess Margaret Hospital for treatment and was later transferred to Prince of Wales Hospital in Sha Tin. Sources indicated the woman was climbing over a fence when she fell into the Joss paper furnace. Four firefighters were sent to rescue her. Three of them were injured during the rescue and were taken to Yanchai Hospital for treatment. One of them sustained 70% burns to his legs and requires hospitalization. The other two injured firefighters were discharged after treatment. The Fire Services Department spokesperson said the firefighters wore protective wear, but the furnace wasn't completely extinguished when they entered. The temperature inside was between 400 and 600 degrees Celsius. The protection can withstand 8 seconds of 1,000 degrees Celsius of heat, and it took the firefighters 3 minutes to rescue the woman. The spokesperson also noted that their protective gear wasn't damaged. The incident is now under investigation. The police said the woman was alone and did not bring any offerings with her. Signs were put up next to the front warning worshippers of the high heat. Caleb Lulong, TVB News.
The driver sustained injuries after he fell from his horse during a race at Shanti course. The incident happened during the ninth race of the day, involving rider Alex Lai and his horse G1 Lover. Lai felt pain in his lower back after tumbling to the track. He was conscious when taken to Prince of Wales Hospital for treatment. The horse went on to finish the race without its jockey.
The Housing Authority is installing special soundproof windows. The goal is to help mitigate traffic noise at public housing units near busy roads. King Tai Court in San Po Kong is the first to try them out. The development of these particular windows took 2 years of work by the authority. The design includes a window that opens on the outside and a sliding window within the inner layer. It allows opening for ventilation while noise absorbent material is installed between those layers to enhance noise reduction.
More overseas news. The Manchester music venue where a suicide bomber killed 22 people as they left an Ariana Grande concert in May reopened last night for the first time since the attack. The benefit concert aimed to raise money for a charitable trust in charge of establishing a memorial to the victims of the atrocity. Tony Sabine reports.
I want to say to you, Manchester, thank you for being who you are and doing what you do. And tonight, we send out this strong message. We are Manchester, a city united. Nothing will ever change us. Nothing will ever divide us. Have a great night, everybody.
And with that, the mayor helped begin a charity concert to mark the reopening of the Manchester Arena, raise funds for victims of an extremist attack at a venue on May the 22nd. The attack, which happened at the end of an Ariana Grande concert, left 22 people dead and scores more wounded. Many of those hurt or killed were minors. Before the concert, the mayor recited the names of the 22 lost in the bombing. 14,000 or so fans inside the arena cheered and clapped as the names were recited. Among the performers at the special concert was Noel Gallagher, who was part of the famous Manchester band Oasis. Local poet Tony Walsh summed up the mood of defiant optimism.
We are musical. We are multicultural. We are Manchester. We are magnificent. And we are back.
The benefit concert, entitled We Are Manchester, was organised to raise money for a charitable trust in charge of establishing a permanent memorial to the bombing of the city. Tony Savine, TVB News.
In Peru, more than 60 homes were destroyed overnight by a massive fire that engulfed an entire neighbourhood. This tragedy erupted in the Peruvian city of Iquitos. Fire sparked panic among residents who rushed to remove personal belongings from their homes. Firefighters battled the blaze and managed to prevent it from spreading to other areas. Authorities are relieved that no deaths were reported. All right, Jeff, I want to thank you for being a trooper and filling in as my last-minute anchor. Bless okay. your soul. What do you have for us in sports today?
Some good wrestling action close to home.
Excellent.
Hong Kong's pro wrestling fans are getting pumped up about next weekend's big show in Shenzhen. As Jameson Wong reports, this may be the closest some diehard fans will get seeing the heroes in action.
It isn't easy being a fan of professional wrestling in Hong Kong. Television programs from the United States disappeared locally long ago. Still, Typho Ho Ho Loon went on to become a pro wrestler and promoter, learning the trade in Japan, Europe, and America. The 30-year-old realized a dream recently, signing with the top outfit around, the WWE. He was part of the company's developmental division, NXT, based in Florida.
Maybe one day I can work in the WWE, but it always only happen in the imagination. But when it come true, it feels really, really exciting for me.
And he brought the experience back home, where he's focused on promoting professional wrestling and his Hong Kong Pro Wrestling Federation.
Now we run two major events in Hong Kong, one in summer, one in winter, and also some small events. We draw about 200 to 400 fans each time in Hong Kong.
Ni hao! What the means is your John Cena!
Ho Ho's mission coincides with the WWE's big push into China. Next Sunday in Shenzhen, the WWE returns with its heroes and villains and predetermined outcomes. Last year, the promotion held an event in Shanghai. It also began offering live streams of its shows in Putonghua. As for the future product, the WWE signed a number of Chinese athletes with the hopes of creating a Chinese superstar. Richard Tang is a fan and blogger.
This sport is wrestling. It's nothing more like wrestling. It's unique. I just wish more people understand what this sport is all about.
Once upon a time, pro wrestling fans, when talking about their guilty pleasure, may have felt compelled to emulate their heroes and hide behind a mask. Nowadays, that's not the case, with strength in numbers.
Not just a big thing in the United States, pro wrestling is wildly popular in Mexico, parts of Europe, and Japan. In China, fans are now just catching on. WWE Greater China claims more than 1 million followers on its social media platforms. Not a bad beginning to a story whose ending, unlike its matches in the ring, has yet to be scripted. Jameson, TVB News.
Tennis now, and Sloane Stephens claimed the first Grand Slam singles title at the U.S. Open in New York. In the All-American final, Stephens defeated good friend Madison Keys in straight sets. Scores were 6-3 and 6-love. The one-sided match lasted just 61 minutes. 6 weeks ago, Stephens was coming off an injury and ranked outside the top 100 in the world. The 24-year-old became only the fifth unseeded woman to win the championship at Flushing Meadows. Good night.